It's a viral sensation. We first showed you last week, and it is still picking up momentum here in the Midwest. People with an adventurous side are taking the plunge to raise money for a very sick baby in Missouri.
But tonight, a warning from an Iowa sheriff to be careful that you don't hurt yourself or break the law. Mark Tauschek is here to explain.
Well, guys, this all started almost 2 weeks ago down in Tarkio, Missouri, where five-month-old Landon Shaw lives with his family. Landon has stage 4 brain cancer that has spread rapidly through his body. His battle has spawned a viral phenomenon that has swept into Iowa. People's hearts are in the right places, but a warning tonight to not put the rest of their bodies in danger.
If you haven't seen the videos yet, they are multiplying. And that's good news for the family of Landon Shaw. Since each plunge comes with a promise of a monetary donation if a challenge to another person is accepted.
I will donate $30 if Matt Johnson, head coach of the St. Joe Mustangs, completes the challenge.
But one woman was injured when she jumped into shallow water at Rapp Park near Shenandoah. And to add insult to injury, she was ticketed for trespassing because swimming is not allowed in that location.
Even though it's cold, it doesn't hurt to go out there first and know what's down there. It's not a good idea just to go over to a bank and jump in. That can get very dangerous very quickly.
Sheriff Palmer advises people who want to plunge for Landon to get creative with swimming pools, tubs, really big tubs. But it's hard to temper enthusiasm.
The farmer and I are going to jump in. And
when Iowans are given a chance to help someone in need.
You guys are gonna have to pull us out.
Now, Sheriff Palmer down in Clarinda thinks it's a great idea. In fact, he took the plunge himself. He just says, don't take unnecessary risks and obey the local rules. For instance, there's been at least one of these plunges for Landon at Gray's Lake here in Des Moines. That's breaking park rules because it doesn't open for swimming until after Memorial Day. And according to Des Moines police, it's also breaking the law. City code would require written permission from the city to swim in an unsupervised place out of season. Stacy.
Okay, Mark, thank you.
Well, many